and welcome to my channel. Today I have a video for you of a nail art, which is probably obvious by my hand being in the screen here. It's a little bit more intricate, well, a lot more intricate than my other Halloween look of this year, so let's get started. So, yeah, let's just start with the basics and specifically with the products I use today and the tools. I started out with a background nail polish, well, just a nail polish that I happen to use as a background. Of course, you can use whatever color you want, you can use whatever type of nail polish you want. I'm using my acrylic nails, I always do acrylic on myself, but you can also of course do this on natural nails. The nail polish I used is a gel nail polish, and I'm not actually sure if you can actually use it on your natural nails. Do always be careful with that, by the way. If you do any tutorials or like any nail art look on your natural nails and you want to use gel polish, do make sure to use a gel polish that is actually formulated to be used on natural nails, because otherwise, well, for example, I have some that dry up really, really, really stiff, which doesn't matter on acrylic nails because they don't bend to begin with, but your natural nails do, and you don't want the acrylic or you don't want the gel polish to crack and tear your natural nail along with it, because that would probably hurt very much. So yeah, do always be careful with that. But yeah, the polish I use is a gel polish that actually reacts to temperature. When it's cold, it's this color, and throughout this video, you'll probably see it getting a little bit brighter. When it's warm, and I had my hand underneath the lamp, so my hands did get warm during this video. When it's really warm, the nail polish turns bright purple, which, I don't know, I thought the color shift was just a pretty cool thing for a Halloween look, as well as a nighttime look. You know, because it's still sort of nighttime, but sort of like between light and day. Light and day, night and day. So yeah, that was pretty much my idea behind it. Then I also used acrylic paint, very cheap acrylic paint, so I had to use multiple layers of it at multiple points to actually get it to be completely opaque. But I always figure with acrylic paint on my nails, I don't mind if I have to go over it twice. I'd rather use cheap acrylic paint because, let's face it, it's not going to stick on my nails for the next 500 years. It's never going to be in a museum, it's going to get filed off again in a week or two. So it doesn't have to last forever, so I don't want to spend like a huge amount of money on acrylic paint, so I just use a cheap version. I also use nail art brushes. I got these off eBay or Born Pretty Store, either one of the two. And most of them I actually cut down, or at least I removed most of the hairs, just chopped them off to make them even thinner to get all the details I want. And yeah, other than that, the technique I'm using, well, pretty much my idea is I wanted it to be sort of in backlight, like the moon, and that's the round, big, white thing currently, not very recognizable as a moon in the middle nail, by the way. But yeah, it's sort of lighting the characters and everything else from behind. I really wanted to keep that effect by having sort of the glow around them, like light around them. And the easiest way to get that is to just get a white silhouette first. And then not quite completely fill it in with color. Just so you get sort of a sloppy, uneven white outline that just looks like it's like, you know, the light is sort of glowing around them. Also, it will make the colors pop a lot more, which is also a reason why I do it, especially on dark nail polishes. It can be pretty difficult to actually see what you've painted if you use dark colors or really any colors at all, and it dries and it just is less opaque maybe. And it just all gets very dark and difficult to see, and with a white base underneath it, everything is just going to pop way more, which is also why I do that. But yeah, I just painted the white silhouettes first, which also gives me a vague idea of where exactly I want my characters to be. Then I add in the color and with that a little bit more detail, and then the final details. And yeah, that's pretty much the technique I used. Then about the actual characters I painted, I decided to go for pretty much classic, maybe slightly cliche Halloween images, but I wanted to make them more intricate and just sort of vintagey looking. I don't know, but we've really been into vintage things lately. But I decided to go for a creepy tree and a witch and a bat, which is flying away from a castle, so it's probably a vampire. British going to guess that. And yeah, which are just classical creepy things, in most cultures at least. You know, because like all trees, they used to think they, you know, old-timey people of like hundreds of years ago, used to think that, like, you know, the typical creepy old tree, like, you know, the gnarly ones, the ones with all the branches in weird, crooked angles, and they're dead, yet the tree is still standing, and it's large, and it's huge, and it's imposing, and it's creepy. They used to believe the trees like that were haunted by, you know, forest spirits and stuff like that. The types of forest spirits are pretty much different in every country, but yeah, basically it was a well-known thing that you should never chop a tree like that down, because if you would, you would probably get cursed by some horrific creature, or at least a creature that would turn horrific if you'd piss it off, and it would be very angry if you would chop down the tree where it lived, or, you know, was haunting the place, whatever. So yeah, trees like that were usually regarded as something to leave alone. Then witches, of course, witches, you know, they've always been part of pop culture and, like, you know, legends and stuff. One fun fact, by the way, I read it somewhere, is that witches weren't actually always taught to fly on broomsticks. Some people actually believe that witches would leave their broomstick at home when they would go to, like, witch sabbats and all, and turn it into a copy of themselves to fool their husbands into thinking they were just sleeping beside them. And instead they would fly on, like, other garden equipment, which I think would look very funny. So yeah, my witch, well, you know, you can only see the stick, so if it's a broomstick or whatever else sort of garden equipment, you don't know. But I do think broomsticks just look better in images. Then, of course, the classic vampire. Yeah, this one is just flying away from its castle in bed shape, presumably to get himself a drink. And lastly, I'm just applying top coat, because acrylic paint washes off in water, so top coat is pretty important to make sure that the nail polish, or the nail art, I mean, is actually going to last. And that's the final result. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. I really enjoyed painting it. I love painting stuff on my nails, and I love Halloween and Halloween-themed things, so painting Halloween-themed stuff is always one of my favorite things to do. If you did enjoy this video, please click the like button, it would really help me out. And if you want to, you can also subscribe to my channel. I actually mostly do makeup tutorials, but also regularly nail art tutorials. Yeah. And yeah, below the video, as always, you can find a full list of all the products I've used today. You can also find a full list of all my social media accounts and names there. Mostly active on Instagram, and I'd really love it, especially if you'd want to follow me there, because I always share there as well whenever I upload a new video onto my YouTube channel. And yeah, other than that, thank you very much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!